And I'm like, Lord, I know what's coming. Hey, I hear you. But what about right now? While I'm here on this earth, what about now? He says, he leads me to Romans chapter 8, verse 18, where Paul says, for I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us.
Amen. Amen.
That Paul is somehow agreeing with John in the fact that we will have times in this life while we are on earth that we will suffer. Inasmuch as we want to get around it, there will come times in our lives that we have to suffer. There will be times that we will have to experience pain.
Yes, sir.
There will be times we'll have to experience trials and tribulations and troubles.
Yes,
I think I got about 10 people here this morning who can testify that there are times in this life that we will have trials, tribulations, and troubles.
Yes,
and John said, it does not yet appear what we shall be. In fact, we don't even have a clue of what's going to happen in the future. But while we're here, Paul also says, and we know that all things work together for good to them who love God, those who are called according to his purpose.
Then
I'm trying to tell you that whatever you go through,
amen,
know that God is working it out,
amen,
for your good.
Yes,
Lord. Even though you don't understand, and I think I got about 3 people who can testify that there are some things we don't understand.
Yes.
We don't understand why life treats us the way life does sometimes. We don't understand why some people treat us the way they treat us sometimes.
Uh-huh.
We don't understand why life turns one way and turns the other way. Don't understand why things happen the way they happen. Why our families turn out like they do. Why children do the things they do. Why wives and husbands do the things they do. Why people just do the things they do.
Well.
But we do understand that it does not yet appear what we shall be.
Mm-hmm.
That's all God's saying. I'm just a work in progress.
Amen.
Oh, but when he shall appear,
yes.
When we shall behold his face,
yes.
When we shall see him face to face.
Oh, yeah.
In one translation it says, what we know is that when Christ is openly revealed,
uh-huh,
Right says, we'll see him, and in seeing him, we will become like him.
Well.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
All of us, the writer says, who look forward to his coming, stay ready.
Yes, sir.
With the glistening purity of Jesus' life as a model for our own. So until he appears, God is saying, live a life that will look like the life that Jesus lived here on earth.
Yes.
And you know what kind of life he lived.
Yes.
He lived a life that glorified his Father.
Yes.
And all I'm telling us this morning is, as long as God has us here, let's live a life that will bring God glory.
Yes, sir.
And I know that in this life, as we are a work in progress, I have to tell you, God is still working on it.
Yes.
Can I get a witness in here? God is still working. working on me. I am a work in progress. Please be patient with me. God is not through with me yet. But when the Lord gets through with me, but John. get to heaven, I want to see mama. But not just first. I don't have to see papa first. I don't have to see loved ones first. But if I can look at the face of Jesus, the one who died on me, if I can get hold his face and carry it on, thank you, Lord, for all the trials you brought me through. Well, the Lord, thank you, Lord, for all the troubles you brought me through.
Without ordinary. And that's who God chooses and he uses ordinary people. accomplish extraordinary things. And God has something extraordinary